This is SkyWatch Media News for July 3rd, 2019. Here's what's happening. According to model findings by astrophysicist Valentina Zarkova, our sun is about to enter into a deep solar minimum that will last for decades. With the release of this presentation, Zarkova clarifies her new findings on the super grand minimum cycle. Her calculations, featured in the June publication of Nature, match up with the timelines of the Maunder minimum. They do so with clear and precise accuracy. So why is this most recent prediction so important? The Earth is witnessing increased unstable weather patterns, prolonged major floods, massive crop failures, and wild swings in temperature, among other extreme events, including high-level volcanic eruptions. These events suggest that we are heading into a time of great and long-lasting changes on our planet. The Maunder minimum is the time period around 1645 to the year 1715, during which sunspots became exceedingly rare. It roughly coincided with the middle part of the Little Ice Age, during which Europe and North America experienced much lower temperatures. NASA and the NOAA are also forecasting very low sunspot activity for solar cycle 25, the lowest in 200 years. But the NOAA forecast is more modest in predicting its time frame, suggesting that the solar minimum will last for years rather than decades, as was predicted by Zarkova in the June issue of the Nature publication. Looking at this chart by independent solar researcher David Birch, it appears that we are already near the Dalton minimum levels that occurred back in the 19th century. If this trend continues, then we may be in the thrust of a solar minimum that could last for many decades. The total solar eclipse that occurred in South America on July 2nd was nothing short of spectacular. Although solar eclipses can happen a few times a year, total solar eclipses are a rarity. The next eclipse isn't due to take place until December of 2020, with the path of totality again cutting across Chile and Argentina. Here are a few amazing images of the total eclipse in the Southern Hemisphere. At the same time as a solar eclipse was passing over Argentina and Chile on July 2nd, a massive hurricane was brewing in the eastern Pacific Ocean, and satellite cameras tracking the path of the eclipse have caught both. The eclipse began over the South Pacific east of New Zealand as the moon moved in between Earth and the sun. The path of totality then made its way east across the ocean, finally making landfall on the coast of Chile and moving across Argentina, treating residents to a rare and spectacular sight. Meanwhile, a major hurricane was percolating above the Pacific Ocean north of the equator and just west of Mexico. Hurricane Barbara, which was officially declared a Category 4 storm, with winds up to 130 miles per hour. These are very interesting times in which we live. So stay informed, keep your mind focused on what's important, and keep looking to the sky.